I'm in shock. I'm in disbelief. I did not think that things would happen the way it did. And the saddest and the saddest part is that I didn't expect this. I didn't expect this from the president that I knew and a president who I trusted fully. Somehow in my heart, in the back of my mind, I still want to believe that this is not true, that he left. But if he did, it's really a shame.
You knew him, you've worked with him as a minister in his government. And only yesterday he was telling the people the army will be remobilized. And now do you feel betrayed?
Not just for me, for the entire nation. It certainly is a betrayal. I was asked earlier on the BBC radio program if I felt betrayed by the international community. And I didn't answer that quite bluntly because I still wanted to believe that we have leaders or leadership in the country that will take care of us. But if this information is true that President Ashraf Ghani and his close team left without informing the nation, then yes, it's a betrayal to the entire nation of Afghanistan.
You're speaking as someone who is a role model for very many people, but you're also there as a citizen and as a mother. What do you think now for your own daughter?
Yes. The fear that every mother has in Afghanistan. The fear that every woman has in Afghanistan. Deep down in my heart, I keep telling myself to think that I haven't done anything bad, and hopefully I won't have to pay the price for joining a government position. But now I might face consequences that I never even dreamed of. And I guess that's the price that we pay for trying to make this world a little better than when we came to it.